So my husband and I, who was my boyfriend at the time, we were on our way from LA to Grand Rapids, Michigan. We were visiting a buddy of ours. We both really like to travel. I mean, we've traveled together since I graduated high school. We toured Europe. We've done the whole thing. He, however, is not a big fan of like the whole getting there aspect, and he tends to get a little crabby. So unfortunately, our flight from Los Angeles to Chicago, where we were planning on then taking the train to Grand Rapids, was delayed by maybe about 2 hours. So by the time we get into Chicago, it's, I don't know, 10, 10:30, close to 11 in the evening. And he's a little bit, you know, on the crabby side already and worried that we're not actually going to make our connection train into Grand Rapids that evening. So we tried to get a flight. I'm trying to keep him as happy as possible at this point in time. And of course the flights are way too expensive for last minute. So we're thinking, okay, let's just go into the city. Hopefully we can get, you know, the last train, we're gonna make it. And the whole time I'm telling him, I'm like, okay, we're gonna make it, we're gonna make it, you know, keep him positive. This is gonna be great, it's fun. I kind of, you know, like having that whole, you know, adventure, we'll see what's gonna happen. So we take the shuttle into the city, and from the shuttle station, it's about a 20-minute walk to the train station. Now what I didn't mention before is, it's January in Chicago. So it's about 32 degrees with like a 20-degree wind chill, and we've got snow on the ground. So we're both walking along, plowing our suitcases through the snow, and I'm getting frustrated because the suitcase keeps flipping up over these little humps of snow, and it's freezing, so every like 2 minutes you have to change hands and stick your hand in your pocket with the gloves and do the whole thing. So, you know, and the whole time he's like grumbling at me, so I'm like, yeah, it's all right, it's gonna be good, we're almost there, we're almost there. So we get to the train station, and sure enough, I get up to the booth, and the last train left about an hour ago. So I'm like, okay, no big deal. We're gonna go, and we're gonna buy the ticket for the first thing in the morning, and I'm telling him, let's stay here at the train station. You know, it's warm, it's already late, I'll stay up and watch the bags, you can sleep. He, of course, was not the biggest fan of the idea of sleeping on these hardwood benches in the train station in public. So I'm thinking, all right, fine, we'll spend a little money, let's go get a hotel, but please let it be somewhere cheap and somewhere close, because we were definitely on a budget. So we met a guy there who was actually from Chicago, and he told us of this place that was just like 2 minutes down the road. It was called something like Jack's Place or something like that, which is kind of, I mean, you want to be a little iffy when you hear a name like that, but I'm thinking, all right, it's got to, you know, it's got to have a bed, we're going to go to sleep, wake up in the morning and go. So we go over to this little place, and we walk into this little trucker hotel, you know, and I'm like, hey, you know, it'll be fun, we've never stayed at a place like this before. We walk into the lobby, and it's kind of like in the movies, where it's like this dingy little lobby, and the guy's sitting in this little wooden booth, and he's like sliding us things under the counter, like at the bank, and it's like $35 for the night, so I'm like, okay, I'm down for $35. He rings the bell, and he's got this like crippled assistant that like comes hobbling out of the back, who then takes us into this tiny little rickety elevator, one of those ones where you actually have to like shut the door behind you, and we're like squished there. He takes us down the hall upstairs, and then he takes the padlock off of the room door. At this point, I'm, you know, trying to be encouraging, but inside I'm like, oh my gosh, we're gonna die. This is a horrible place, but you know, I'm like, there's a bed, we're gonna go to sleep. So the door locks from the inside. We go inside, and there's like, it smells like smoke. I mean, there's ashtrays everywhere. It's this crazy trucker hotel. We counted like 50 ashtrays or something. There's cigarette burns and everything. And I'm just pushing Jason. I'm like, go, you know, go lay down, go to sleep. I mean, above the shower, there's these little wires dangling where the light's broken. I'm thinking that's, you know, not really a good thing. So we both go sit on the bed to, you know, take off our shoes and go to sleep. And I'm like, finally, you know, we're done. I'm so relieved right now. As we sit on the edge of the bed, the mattress flips up and hits us on the back of the head and slides down. And I'm just like, I'm done right now. This is all I've got. I couldn't even say anything to him. I was like, I have no more encouraging words for you right now. We're just gonna go to sleep and pretend it's all a bad dream. Which we did, and unfortunately the next morning we were, you know, still there. Fortunately we were still alive, so I was happy. I mean, we've never booked it out of a hotel so fast in our entire lives. But we made it to the train station, we made it to Grand Rapids, and all things considered, we had a pretty good story to tell. I mean, the best part of the whole experience, honestly, was that from now on, whenever he like tries to hold something above my head or says he has a better idea, I'm always like, yeah, remember that time in Chicago? We definitely should have stayed at the train station. Thanks.